Defeated and totally changed the back to the mechanism did slip in the other governing parties. In fact, they are going backwards to go militarism. So let's see the Fukushima effect going on there. In fact, this nuclear catastrophe is far from the over. After almost 5.5 years later now, finally people found the forest located of the one of three melted reactors core. Reactor number two is in the bottom of the pressure buffer. We didn't know where they are. Now finally only one of them can come back, but still they don't know what to do because we don't know the condition of the melted core. Government both want to retrieve it, but experts really warn them that it's too much risk, health risk for the workers. And then release the, so much radioactive material into the atmosphere. So some people suggest to contain it with concrete coffin. But the TEPCO government still want to retrieve it, and then now they are deciding how to do it. It is still so much daunting task, building up like a mountain. The thousand contaminated water in the already facility lab. And then the billions of dollars spent to make ice wall are not incidentally functioning as people expected. Still, the contaminated water is seeping to the ocean. Childhood cancer among the children are increasing. Over 170 kids had cancer and suspected to have it. And February and March this year, I think, Greenpeace Japan studied, researched the bottom of the sea bed near Fukushima. Then they said that the hundreds of times above the pre-2011, even the riverbed, the local riverbed, those are even 200 times more than the seabed. But amazing, those areas are the government is planning to bring people back. 2017, so next year, March, government is focusing to bring back many people there. But those areas, wow, 39,800 becquerel per kilogram. It's called radiocarcinogenic, hard to say. But anyway, those places, governments are trying to bring people. Decontamination, they said, is really, I don't think it's possible. And then, let's see, this is one of Greenpeace article that they said. The lifting of evacuation orders in March 2017 for areas that remain highly contaminated is looming human rights crisis, and they cannot be permitted to stand. The vast expanses of the contaminated forest and the fresh water system will remain a perennial source of radioactivity for the foreseeable future, as these ecosystems cannot simply be decontaminated. The pending 20 Olympic is coming, people's attention is really shifted from the problem of Fukushima. In Takae, in Okinawa, people are protesting to build the U.S. Army's helicopter launch pad. But Abe is sending special military to suppress them. Also to the Senoko, the people against make new base there. Abe government is just crushing people, just harassing people, never listen people's voices. That's why we are here. Because if we just be silent and didn't say anything, and we are just mad about him, so that. That doesn't work. We have to, put our voice out and stand up. We have to protest government. Thank you. So, please, yes.
Thank you, Chizu. So, it's amazing. Nearly 50 months, every day for 50 months we've been here, once a month. And we have to continue to be here to make our voices heard. We have some good news. In China, the Chinese government wants to build 60 nuclear plants. And they want to build a nuclear reprocessing plant. And this past week, there were demonstrations of thousands of people in this community to protest this nuclear reprocessing plant. So the government now has said that they don't want, they're rethinking building this nuclear processing plant. So that's a good sign that the people of China are waking up. And the people of China are aware of what happened in Fukushima. They're aware of this catastrophe and the dangers of nuclear power. And China, like Japan, as an earthquake area, they have mass earthquakes in China that kill thousands of people. So the Chinese people do not want to have another Fukushima. The question we have is, why is it that the Abe government, despite the fact that hundreds of thousands of Japanese people have protested, are continuing to try to restart these nuclear plants? This week they announced they're going to be starting another nuclear plant, restart another plant. This despite the fact that they haven't solved their safety problems. We also condemn the Abe government for the hiring of contract workers by subcontractors. Many of these are hired by the mob there, and they don't have proper training and proper protection, these contract workers. So the government, TEPCO, which really controls TEPCO, is allowing the subcontracting out of the work by and having it run by the Yakuza. Many of these day laborers who are working at the plant to clean it up are not given proper training, they're not given protection, and if they get cancer, if they get the diseases caused by radiation, they're not going to be protected. Some of them are migrant workers as well. So the other question we have to ask is, this past year, President Obama went to Hiroshima to give recognition about the disaster. However, he refused to apologize for the bombing of Hiroshima and Nagasaki. So why did President Obama refuse to apologize? Why? The United States had no right to bomb the cities of Hiroshima and Nagasaki. Civilians were killed, and even American prisoners were killed in Hiroshima and Nagasaki. We say that we have to stop nuclear weapons. We have to stop nuclear plants. And in fact, the U.S. government is spending billions trying to modernize our nuclear bombs. Now, why would you want to modernize nuclear bombs unless you plan to use them someday? And this is the great danger that people in the United States and people in Asia face, because the United States is militarizing Asia. They want to build another base in Okinawa. They want to support the base in Jeju. They want a war in Asia. That's what they're provoking with China. They want to militarize the whole region. And it would cost the lives of millions of people. Haven't the Asian people suffered long enough from war? They don't need bombs. They don't need military. They need hospitals. They need education. They need things that will benefit the people, not militarization. So who does this war benefit? Who does the militarization benefit? It benefits bomb manufacturers, the nuclear industry. It benefits weapons manufacturers. It benefits Lockheed Martin and other military companies who benefit from building bombs and building jets. That's who this war benefits, and that's why they're continuing to say that they're going to continue the plants in operation in Japan, because it's a profit. It's about profit. We say we can transform the power industry into solar in California. There's a tremendous increase in solar energy in California. In fact, there's such an increase in solar energy that PG&E doesn't want subsidies anymore. It's trying to prevent us from getting solar in California. Now, that's another reason PG&E should be a public utility, because they're more interested in their profit stream, their revenue stream, than they are in solar energy and efficiency. So it doesn't benefit the people of California. It doesn't benefit the workers. It means more pollution. It means keeping Diablo Canyon open. And we oppose this extension of the license of Diablo Canyon. Diablo Canyon is a danger. There could be an earthquake at any time there, which would be another Fukushima in California. It would threaten the Imperial Valley. It would threaten millions of people in California with contamination. We cannot afford another Fukushima. So we're saying defend the people of Fukushima, repatriate the children, stop the secrecy laws and the militarization in Japan, which is preventing people from finding out about the dangers of radiation. There is an increase of thyroid cancer surgeries in Japan. The government is refusing to allow people to know about that. They don't want people to know. They're keeping it a secret from the people. We say end the secrecy law, stop militarization, shut down the nuclear plants, keep them shut, and also open up solar and let's have alternative energy. So thank you, brothers and sisters, for joining us. Shut down all the plants. Shut down all the plants.
Shut down all the plants.
Shut down all the nukes.
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 Thank you, Steve. So, as you know, we went the letter to Prime Minister over time. So we were sort of holding time for this time. Community educational education project. So much people were better than so she also reached it out.
Thank you, everyone. I came here today to express something very important, and also at a very urgent problem they have in they cover the child baby up to 18 years old, but not older. So they are out of funds, they are suffering. So they are asking for Hibakutecho, just like they gave after the Hiroshima bomb. They are protected all through life, at least medical expense. So anyway, I wrote this letter to you, and today I brought my great granddaughter, Kalea. You would like to come over here? She's 5 years old.
Kalea.
But this is very concerned for not only for us, but for my older generations to come. So I start August 6, 2016. Dear Mr. Abe, Prime Minister of Japan, and Japanese Parliament members. I am the citizen of Japan who resides in San Francisco, California, USA. I am writing this letter to you all for the behalf of my friends in Fukushima and the people of neighboring prefectures. I am a survivor of an atom bomb dropped on Hiroshima on August 6, 1945. Fortunately, on that day, my family was out of Hiroshima City for visiting his relatives outside in the mountains. But coming back to catch a train to Hiroshima, the train supposed to be arrived at 7:30 a.m. But that train was delayed, they never came. And from there, at the station, of my parents witnessed that atom bomb was dropped at 8:15. If that train came on time, 7:30, I wouldn't be here because I was in my mother's family. So today, I want to continue this message. After the terrible mass, the people who survived was giving Hibakutecho, the head note of nuclear disaster victim certificate document, which they can receive any treatment regarding to any sickness. Although the suffering from the nuclear radiation was unspeakable and many people died from effects and still suffering continue to this day and not finished yet. Nevertheless, Fukushima people are excluded for this benefit from March 11, 2011 on to this day. Most of the citizens must pay the hospital expenses and doctor's fees, medical medicines, etc. from their own pocket, and most of the people cannot afford. So I pray the attention for all the people in Fukushima and neighboring prefectures. This is illegal for human rights. We are responsible to taking care of each other, citizens as in democratic country. Japanese always value one, means harmony. Over the 2,000 years in our history, in which we live, Japanese, please don't forget that we are responsible for taking care of each other. You are giving that opportunity. Once again, we should look towards Fukushima's Genpas nuclear power plant and ask the right solution for that will help people of victim of nuclear disaster. Fukushima nuclear disaster is not finished yet, and we must sincerely create and face in the solution of our planet. Planet Earth to be safe place in 21st century. We as Japanese and Americans have strong commitment to ask you, Mr. Abe, and members of Japanese Parliament, will you have great heart to listen to our voice? Truly, yours, Machiko Conway, in San Francisco, California.
Thank you.
And I have a message from the Fukushima, Hibakusha, so I want to just read it for a few more minutes. This is a message from the adult victim. Radiation, heat, rock, and death, genetic effects created a hell on Earth. 71 years ago, the number of nations enormous of evil and enslaved by nuclear weapons is increasing. The human family stands at the crossroads. Will all nations be enslaved or will all nations be liberated? The voice, another question. It is accessible for cities and especially the innocent children who live in them to be targeted by nuclear weapons. The answer is crystal clear, and the past 71 years have shown us the path to revolution, from a hell in which no one could have blamed them for chosen death. The Hibakusha set forth towards life and the future, living with injuries and illness eaten away at body and mind. They have spoken persistently about their experience, refusing to bow before discrimination, slander, scorn. They have warned continuously that no one else should ever suffer as we do. Their voices, picked up by the people of conscience the world over, are becoming a powerful mass chorus. The key rule of peace, the only rules for nuclear weapons is to be abolished. And yet the world political leaders continue to ignore these voices. The International Court of Justice advisory opinion handed down 20 years ago, born of the creative action of citizens and society should have been a highly effective tool for enlightening and guiding them towards the truth. The court found that the threat of use of nuclear weapons was generally contrary to the rule of international law, and went on to declare the existence and obligations pursued in good faith and bring to us. Negotiation leads to nuclear disarmament in all its aspects under strict and effective international control. If a nuclear weapon state has taken the lead and sought in good faith to fulfill its obligation, nuclear weapons would have been abolished already. Unfortunately, during the past 20 years, most nations and most people have failed to confront this obligation head on. Regretting that we have not done more, the city of Hiroshima, along with mayors of peace, whose members have been launching phase two of our 2020 vision campaign. This phase includes a good faith challenge, a campaign to promote the good faith negotiation for nuclear disarmament process in the ICJ Advisory Opinion and a city are not targeted. Project, he said, demanding that nuclear weapons stop targeting cities for nuclear attacks. Nuclear weapons are illegal, immoral weapons designed to obliterate cities. Our goals are to rebuild the delusion behind nuclear deterrence and the nuclear umbrella, which holds cities hostage and to protect from a legal and moral standard, moral point our citizens' life to life. Taking the lead in this effort, the U.S. Conference of Mayors representing 1,149 American cities at its national meeting this past few years, the USPS adopted resolutions demanding that all nuclear weapons stations in the United States immediately cease all targeting of cities with nuclear weapons. Cities and citizens of the world have a duty to release the drop sheet from the spread and liberate the world from nuclear weapons. The time has come for all of us to awaken and arise with the will that can penetrate rocks and the passion that burns like fire. This is a message from the victim of the Hiroshima. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, Machiko-san. He needs the country. He's not so much targeted to develop the even future disruptive nuclear warheads. I think in the U.S. there are more than 200 nuclear warheads. That's 1,000 times stronger than the Hiroshima Nagasaki bomb. And even the next president candidate, Donald Trump, said that the possibility, he's holding the possibility of the using nuclear weapons. And even the another candidate, Clinton, said that president should not say no or yes about using nuclear weapons. She is suggesting that the possibility to use weapons. We must realize that we are facing a very dangerous world, that nuclear war might happen any time. The world is very high tension about the nuclear weapons, and we really here to stand, abolish entire nuclear weapons and then nuclear plants. And maybe Steve wants to say to do.
Militarization, not just in Japan, but in the United States. The United States supports the militarization of Japan. And Donald Trump said that they should pay more money if they want the United States military to stay in Japan. I say they should leave Japan. It's not a question of money. As the U.S. mercenaries, they should get out of Japan, they should get out of Korea, they should get out of Asia. The United States has no business with over 700 military bases all over the world. What are the purpose of these bases? The purpose are not to help people. The purpose are to dominate the world militarily. That's why we have all these bases. When people in San Francisco don't have a place to sleep, when people don't have medical care, it seems we have an unlimited amount of money for bombs and weapons and more military bases. This is a crime against the people of this country. The real income of Americans is dropping. And the union busters, these companies, these corporations that both the U.S. and Japanese company government represents, are not interested in the people, they're interested in more militarization. That is why the United States is supporting the rearming of Japan. That is why they continue to spend money on nuclear weapons and safe nuclear technology, they say. They want to build small nuclear power plants that are safe. But nuclear waste is a product of these nuclear plants, whether they're small or big. And nuclear waste is dangerous to the people. There's an epidemic of cancer in the United States. And particularly in nuclear plants, like Diablo Canyon, and also in the Southern California. So we have to say we're opposed to any more nuclear plants. We're for the closure of Diablo Canyon. We say it was a victory that San Onofre closed in Southern California. And we have to close all U.S. nuclear plants. We have to stop any danger that there could be a meltdown at these plants. So would anybody else like to speak? We have an open mic here. Any words of support? A solidarity?
Okay, so next speaker is demnding. From the shuttle of concern and no distraction.
Oh, you can step?
I wanted just to read a little bit from an article from this bill. They have a center. People are full-time opposing the Trite submarine base in Bangor in Washington State. And this is part of the nuclear triad, which is news to Donald Trump. But it's one of the most deadly aspects of the nuclear program. Each of these submarines carries about 12 ICBMs. Each of those has about 12 missiles. Each of those missiles has chosen said 1,000 times more potent than Hiroshima. So just one of those missiles being launched could be the end of the world. So these people have been at it for decades, and they get arrested, they educate, they try to interact with the people who work on the base. They really are devoted to creative nonviolence. Anyway, this is an article, and it has an interesting term in it. We need to change our way of thinking. We need to be responsible. We need a sense of ethics and humility. We are not gods. We are human beings who have evolved from an animal nature. We are still part of nature. Nature will have the last word. As always, nature is negotiating with us as we give rein to our illusions. Our actions must be louder than words.
Thank you, Dan. So we are here 11th of every month. The next meeting here is September 11th. But please don't forget. And the come now, we will need the last shouting.
Okay.